Kia ora, good evening. The death toll in the Whakaari White Island eruption is now 16 after the death of another victim in an Australian hospital. There's disappointment after a second failed attempt today to find two bodies after Monday's eruption. Navy divers continue to look in the water where one of the bodies is believed to be. And the recovery mission on the island also proved fruitless. Four more victims have been formally identified, and the names of five people have now been released. They include Kiwi Tipani James Tirangi Atahua Mangi and Australians Zoa Ella Hosking, her stepfather Gavin Dallow, Anthony Langford and Crystal Browett. We'll cross live to Sam Calway in a moment, but first, his report.
Helicopters carrying the hopes of two families, returning instead with disappointing news.
We've found no further bodies in that area.
A team of eight police, search and rescue staff went back to Whakaari White Island this morning. They searched a ravine leading to the sea where it was thought they might find one of two remaining bodies.
We understand completely how important it is for loved ones to have a body back. So it's not job done when we don't get them back, frankly, so they are frustrated.
Police say there are indications gas levels have dropped, along with volcanic activity, allowing them to carry out the operation instead of the Defence Force. But different breathing equipment limited time on the island. They had just over an hour before being forced to return empty-handed. It's unclear if the body is buried under sediment or whether it's also been washed out to sea.
It's pretty gluggy in there, I think is what it'll be fair to say, and there's an awful lot more sediment in that ravine than there was before the eruption, so you can imagine the conditions underfoot. So that's what's something that we're interested in terms of determining whether it's possible that there is a body in that sediment.
Local chopper pilot Mark Law was among the first responders and also part of today's search.
We knew they were there. We saw them and now they're not. And as time goes, if they're in the ocean, we all know what happens to bodies in the ocean. It's just a time game and it's also a tidal current. We're just up against it.
As an agonising wait for some families continues, for others, finally confirmation of what they already knew. Police formally releasing the names of more victims, including 24-year-old tour guide Tipani Mangi. Earlier this week, Tipani's family told One News he was a lovely, friendly man. Whānau collected his body from Auckland before stopping here this morning at his Whakatane home. They're now making their way down the coast for his tangi.
He's a wonderful boy, he's an awesome kid, Tipani. Everyone knows him, he's well known on the coast, from the small babies right through to the kaumātuas.
Closure of sorts for some, as police promised today, setback won't mark the end of their recovery attempts.
These things cost money, and you know, but I don't think anyone's sitting here counting dollars and saying that's going to be determining. Certainly not at the point we were giving up yet.
Diving teams have also been continuing their efforts as the painful wait for families stretches into another day.
OK, let's go to Sam Calway, who's in Whakatane. Sam, it's been nearly a week, a long week for some people. How do you think they're faring?
It was certainly a different feeling here. I think a lot of local and international media have returned home, but as you heard, police are still determined as ever to return those two bodies. Tomorrow we'll have a one-minute silence. The Prime Minister, Jacinda Ardern, has asked New Zealanders and Australians to stand in solidarity with those who have lost loved ones. This will occur at 2:11 tomorrow afternoon, exactly a week on after the eruption at Whakaari, White Island.
Tēnā koe, Sam. Thank you.